increasingly in the RFPs that I've read, the federal government, and this cuts across Department of Defense, intelligence community, civilian agency, are specifically calling out certifications. The education requirements, excuse me, are fairly consistent. You have to have a bachelor's degree to get in the door to most positions that you might want to have. However, the certifications are very specific. It's a codified way for the customer to understand exactly where your experience lies, the level of experience that you have in order to attain these certifications, and it also points to a certain character, a continued desire to learn and keep getting certified, keep expanding your professional horizons. All of this is a positive from the customer's viewpoint, and they're increasingly calling out very specific clearances. If you look within the DOD, you have the DOD 8570. Very specifically calls out certifications for a variety of levels of position, and it's easy to find. You can Google it, and it also is a very good primer to just get an idea of the steps that one might want to take in getting certified. Specifically, if you were getting into perhaps the systems administration realm, then you're going to start with the basics. You're going to have the Microsoft Certified Professional. You're going to go through the pluses, the A+, Network Plus, Security Plus, and then perhaps specialize, get into the MCSA, the MCSE. If you're a network engineer, Cisco certifications are still the gold standard, but you might want to jump around a little bit. The CCNA is a good starting point, but rather than go directly to the CCNP, what we see is an awful lot of the networks in the government are becoming mixed networks. Juniper has gotten a great deal more market share. So you might go from the CCNA to getting a Juniper certification. You can always go back and get the CCNP. If you're looking in the information security, cybersecurity realm, it's fairly easy. The CISSP is the gold standard, but that does require certain levels of experience, and it is a fairly arduous certification to get. In the shorter run, what is, I suppose, because of the new emphasis on an offensive cybersecurity, you can go through the Certified Ethical Hacker profile. It's only requires 2 years of experience, and you could do it through self-study, so it's maybe a little more cost-effective. The CCIE, there is no such thing as an unemployed CCIE. If you have that particular certification, your career is set for life. It is possibly the most difficult certification to get, but once you have it, life is easy for you. Getting into some of the things that are of interest now, I think obviously virtualization, cloud computing, and typically, particularly in the federal arena, there's going to be a lag time. The certifications are going to have to catch up with whatever is trending technically. So cloud and virtualization certifications are not as numerous as they may be in other realms, but there are a couple. CompTIA offers a cloud essential certification, which is a nice jumping off point. And then the Cloud Security Alliance has two. It's the Cloud Computing Technical Professional and the Cloud Computing Security Knowledge, which is a certificate. Both of these are very interesting. They encompass the breadth of cloud computing. And if you're forward thinking, even if they are not necessarily being called out on RFPs at this point, they will be. And you can be at the head of the line. And at the very least, if you're talking to a prospective employer, even if they don't necessarily understand what it is, they can get that information from you, and it is a value add. So in short, I would say that education is the opening of the door, but particularly in the technical fields, that master's degree in some IT-related field is not going to be as much of a value add to your career as going back and getting these certifications. They are also more focused. They can allow you to specialize in particular areas that are of interest. And I think it is imperative that anybody who truly wants to make a long-term, vital career in this industry has to go out and do this.